Hello and welcome back to Terrain Fever, where before we get started, there are a few things I do need to cover. First of all, summer is really kicking in here in my country and we got sweltering heat. Well, at least in my recording room, or recording studio as I should call it, since quite a few months now. But deal with the heat, which, well, if you do want to know, is 28 degrees and above, I got me, well, very, very basic air conditioning, which all it does is move air around, also known as ventilator. But I got that installed, so you might hear some noise in the background, but that is a necessity. And not something that I can turn off due to me melting otherwise. So, having said that, another thing that has happened, which is more game related, is that we have a new patch. Yes, there is a new version out, which, the main thing they did was they didn't really add any major new features, but they did add a lot of quality of life improvements. Now, I did saw the release notes like, I don't know, a week or what ago, just to check up on them. So I might have forgotten them slightly, but I do believe that, for example, if we go to the replace thingy here, we should be able to see stuff. Well, they did, in any case, because maybe I should have, you know what I'll do, I'll put the, the major changes in the video description, so you can see for yourself, or go over to the website, where you can also find them. But, there are, there is more options here. I don't really know what. We should be able to, see, we can change colors right now, for example. This was one of the features that I clearly recall. Now, we don't really need this line, but that was just to show. things have been happening, things have been improved, made a little bit more sense. I mean, one of the things that you don't see in these videos is that, well, I do save the game, of course. And, for example, when you do save the game, usually it was that you just had to enter the save name and that's it. Now, you can see all the save games, that's a lot easier. So, it's those kind of things, the little things that do make the game a lot more enjoyable to play. It's not like, it doesn't have the clumsy UI anymore. Well, it's still, it still is in its own way a little bit, well, unconventional, but things are being polished more. So that's that, that's the new patch. One of the big improvements is that it runs better. I mean, there's less choppiness and all that, it saves quicker, the save file is smaller, it runs better, so yeah, that's definitely a win, but nothing new has been added. They did say, however, that the next patch, whenever that will be, will come with, and this is joyous news for all of us, X crossings, which mean that, because right now we can only have one crossing at a time, we can then also have the one that would go like this. That is for next time though, or at least next patch. Now, having covered, all the news. Oh, and by the way, you might also hear my laundry machine. Yeah, I know. Recording conditions are suboptimal, but I really wanted to play this game again, so there we have it. Having covered all that, we are going to continue the epic network that we have here as the Locoboys. Now, the last things we did was over here at Brightling Sea, which is all good, it's all fine, but what we've been neglecting is, where it all started. Over here in Newton Le Willows, where we can see that Newton Featherstone has a whopping 73 passengers waiting for it. Now we can also see that we have one train for Newton Rayleigh coming, which will not even be able to take all the passengers. And wow, you know, that's, I mean, that's a thing. Where's the other train? I'm just, is that you? Yeah, that's you. All right, so it kind of makes sense because both trains are relatively close together, you know, that there's more right now because it has had a really long interval without any trains. So it kind of makes sense that this is high. But Newton Featherstone, however, is really worrying because, well, we have one train over here that can take 44. And then the other train is, where was it? Yeah, I believe it was all the way over here. Look, see? So that's like miles away, which means that we do not have enough capacity on the Newton-Lewidlow's line. And since we're looking at this now, I am looking at this horrible bridge over here. And in my eyes, this needs absolute fixing. This is terrible. It's horrible. So what we're gonna do is, well, the bridge itself can stay, because if we remove this, that becomes, it becomes really, really expensive. But what we do need is like a second track for it. And I think it would be easiest if we, you know, go, well, kind of like merge it up over here. So what we're gonna do is this bridge is gonna get a second lane right next to it. Now, they also said, oh, we'll close that. They also said that, I don't know how, but they managed to improve the track builder device thing, you know, that we use to build tracks with. So I'm gonna find out if that is indeed the case. I don't know how they improved it. They said that the performance had been improved. So, well, I guess we'll have to see. We are gonna start out with some track building here, so I'll see you in a bit. Right, well, well, well. I mean, in terms of how they improved the track builder, I'm still not entirely sure. Though what I do notice is that it doesn't really suffer from massive frame drops, you know? It used to kind of like drop down the game's performance a little bit whenever you were constructing tracks, but I don't really notice that right now anymore. However, one thing that I did notice is these. Now, I might have had those the last time we were building, but that's been quite a long while ago, so I don't exactly recall if we did have those available. However, I do quite like them, and from now on, we're gonna use these semi-round traffic light things forever, because, yeah, they look a lot better. Also, and that's a thing that's worrying a little bit more, because I quite like the wooden look of it, we seem to not be able to build, I want this to go up, please. Yeah, look, see, we seem to not be able to build the wooden bridges anymore. I don't know why, really. It's kind of a shame, because I really like these, you know. They're antique right now. They're not available for construction. That's fine. Whatever, you know, we'll deal with it. It's just a shame that it had to be like that. But I guess, you know, since it's 1926 and the First World War is raging in other parts of the country, you know, time's progressing and things move on. Now, as for the amount of passengers that we have over here, I feel that we should add some wagons to the train. So, let us see. It is Newton Featherstone, which does not have anything on replace over here. Now, let me see. What we could do is just add another wagon to it. I mean, there's two ways we could go about this. Or we take one train and we park it in the depot, add another wagon to it, and then, you know, we release it, which I don't know, really. I mean, that's kind of a time-consuming way, and Yeah, we do have a depot over there, but of course none of the trains are really close by, and we lose some valuable loot for that. What we could also do, and that is you know, another option, is use this replace thingy, which I do believe has been enhanced as well. I'm not really sure about that though, but yeah, you know, it is said to be enhanced. So if I were to, you know, set new, oh, I can just add these now? Nice. Alright, so if I just want to add those and I set them both to replace, we have the money for it, so what should happen is that we replace them instantly. Well, I say that, that actually does not need to happen. I mean, I'm gonna leave that as is right now. I do want to know, let's see, finances. No, details. This one can become, what is its maximum age? I don't know that. If I were to 35, and I believe that a quarter of 35 is like 9 years. So it's about at a quarter, which means that it does not get replaced instantly. So the other option that we then have, because we're gonna put this off the replacement, the other option that we then have is to just build a new train, put that on there, and then you know, send the other one to the depot. That way we kind of like just replace them with new ones altogether. I mean, that way we do know for certain that the new trains will be on the line. However, these ones are quite well balanced. Yeah, you know what? No, I mean balanced in terms of like where they are. The one's over here, the other one's over there. We're gonna replace... On the other hand, if I do get a new train vehicle, which I want to use for this one, I cannot replace it because... Ah, well, I can always just do it manually, you know, so... I mean, I'm really torn up. We're gonna do it manually. Right, so, in that case, we will buy this. We will give it 5 compartments. There. And we will set this to line Newton Featherstone. Set line, and be free. Now, I've unpaused the game here. I want this train... you to go to the depot. Yes, go to the depot. So right now the line's still fine. However, all we did really was we just lengthened up the train a bit. Then I need to do this with the other train. So we'll buy this next train there. Now, I can't sit... Whoa, man. Windows spam. It's crazy. Right, so we have the one train there. Now, all I need to do is make sure that the moment you are, like, at the depot over here... The moment he's at the depot over there, I can then release the other train, you know, and send the other one back. That way we should more or less have it balanced out evenly. I guess. In a way. Yeah, you are empty right now, right? Yeah. It's a shame that they lose, you know, the passengers whenever they go to the depot. Really, I mean... I must admit, it might make some sense, but it's a shame nonetheless. I would have loved it if the... You know, if the passengers just stayed. Right. Well, actually, I did not need to buy all these new vehicles, but... That's the way it is. We did get some return on investment, so that's great. And look at this, man. I mean, passengers? Where? What passengers? They're all gone. Which is a shame, because that does mean that this train will have an empty run. At least for the time being. And the other train, right? I mean, that's the interesting bit. You had a goods train. Look at it go. Look at it go. You know, making the switch and you can just continue on. Not at the greatest speeds. Well, that's alright. I mean, I did make these switch-offs, you know, quite... Oh, yeah. These are quite slow, however. That's... Well, you know, this one's quite fast, the one that we have over here. But this one's quite slow. Which means... that eventually... they won't really catch up, I think. But, no, catch up to each other. Hey! Hello, vehicle! Yeah, alright. So, all that we need to do, really, is just keep check of this train until it is at the depot. And then we will be able to deal with it. So, well, let's follow it, shall we? And there they are. Right, money has been made. We are now going to release the trains and send them to their depots. You are gonna be on the Newton Featherstone line. And I don't want to see at which point you exit, because I really pray that it will be the same direction as the other train. And if that's so, you can... Yes, you can go to the depot right now. Nice! Alright, so that's that sorted. There are a few other things that we do need to take a look at. One of them being the Mablethorpe Sutton Goods, which runs over here. And I don't really know, where is that train right now? It is not you, you are the passenger line. It is over here. Is that still... Yeah, it's 14 minutes. I mean... I guess so, in a way. It is quite long, so maybe that does make sense. I don't know, really. Alright, as long as it stays at 14 minutes, it's kind of good. The other one is the Brightling Sea Goods train, which is also somewhat worrying. In that, if it stays too long over here... We'll have to take a look at the cargo. Yeah, nothing's moving up the path towards Brightling Sea just yet. But I believe it's you, right? It's getting there. It's getting there. Just need to go up, though, with its... Wait, what? You are... How? Why are you also receiving iron? That's not right. Alright, so this, I mean, that the fact that this is 15 minutes is because the loading over here takes incredibly long. No, I don't want to group anything. I want to check Brightling Sea. Yeah. This needs to go up, you know, and then once that goes up, then the loading over here will go quicker. See, once the production goes up, you should depart any moment now. Yeah, alright. So, then the other thing that was worrying, or at least slightly, was the train over here. Now, as far as I can tell, it's just not coping. So, what we're gonna do is, we are going to get ourselves another train here. Not as, like, you know, a secondary train, but as the replacement of. Because I have noticed that this one has been on... replacement like forever, this one, and it's just not getting replaced. Now that's probably because the train's life isn't it's wait, hold on a second, if I click this, 40 years, then it still should have been replaced a long time ago. So we don't really know why this is not getting replaced, but what I do know is that I can't be arsed waiting for it, so we're going to do this manually by hand. There. This should do it. We will set this to... this was a sandy wood, wasn't it? There. Yes, it was. We'll put that off the replacement. And the Rayleigh Goods Line, is that... This has been replaced. So So we'll put that off, otherwise it will just keep replacing it. And that means that all our trains are now nice and dandy. Now, I'm not going to send this one train to the depot with all the wood on it. I am gonna make it finish its round. But once it is delivered the wood, then we will immediately decommission it and we will send it to the depot to sell it for profit. So there you have it. You try and ship my goods. Right, so that means that the production part of it all is quite well. And look at these, man. These are like the equivalent of, well, you know, historical skyscrapers in my eyes, you know. Wow, look at that. Looking good. Oh, and 61 for Mablethorpe Sandy? Alright, well, that means that we need another train over there, because if I'm not mistaken, Mablethorpe Sandy has, let me see, Mablethorpe Sandy, yeah, it only has one train. Right, that means that we're gonna add another one, which might bring down the profit a little bit of it, but I don't think it's such a bad idea. Right, so we'll add another 4 to it. And it doesn't really matter, you know, well, it kind of does. I do want it to be spaced out evenly. You're the one with the, yeah, you're the one with the 3. Right, so you should go to the depot right now. I hope I didn't miss the point to, no, just in time. However, I do want to know, like, where the Mablethorpe and Sutton train is. It's not there. I wonder, if I set this to anywhere, I mean, let's face it, the depot is kind of, well, we're just gonna have to check out where this one goes. Right, so it opens up, please go into that direction. Oh, it does! Perfect, because the train right now is entering the tunnel, so. Nice, nice, nice. Things are going extremely well, let me tell you. Look at this, we're running green figures pretty much everywhere. Well, not everywhere, but close to everywhere. Like, Leominster Goods isn't running profits. That is because Leominster itself is just a slacking city that does not develop. There. Now that you know it, please take action. Look at this, see? It's slacking in development. It's like going up, and then here it's like flattening off. So no wonder it's not making as massive profits. I mean, if you take a look at Rayleigh on the other hand, Rayleigh is showing how it's supposed to be done. Right, very good. By the way, now that we're here, we might as well, I mean, this might look like a lot, but really, it isn't really that much. Now that we're here, we might as well take a look at stuff like over here, for example. How well are you filled up? Well, that's looking alright, actually. Alright, 60 in production. Alright, now looking good, looking good. Nothing to complain about. 2 petrol. Try and ship more goods. So that's all down to the development of Stockton-on-Tees, which does show a growing trend. Even though, you know, it might have its individual dips every now and then, it does show a growing trend. Also, I mean, we have, wow, speaking about skyscrapers, man. 25 freaking residents. 24. I'm wondering, should we add like a train or a bus or a, I think we have buses over here, bus line over here. No, we're not going to, not needed. And over here, I think production has been just mighty fine. 84 and rising. Now, how much do you have? Yeah, you can still load up quite a bit more, actually. You try to deliver more coal. Alright. However, try to deliver more coal. Oh, you can ship 130 product. So if we deliver more coal, how much do you need to load? Not that much, actually. So this is just going up, I assume, right? Yeah, it should be. I mean, the production over here should just keep going up. Okay, we'll keep this window open here. And, well, you know, with the, I mean, these were some adjustments that needed to be made. I mean, let's face it, you know, this Oh, yeah. Look at this, an 84. So, my assumption here is right. Production is going up, so the whole iron situation that we had, where was it now? Over here. I mean, this would just, you know, keep going up. So, this is just a matter of time before it's all maxed out. So, that's good. This, however, a new vehicle. We're going to check it out. Maybe we can even use it. By trains. It's also electric. It is the AE 4th, 4/7th. It can go 100 kilometers an hour. It costs 600k a year versus 690k a year over here. So it is as fast but cheaper. It has a hell of a lot more power, more tractive effort, and it has a longer lifespan. It's also cheaper to buy. Oh my good lord. If we convert all of these locomotives to these ones, we will be running an insane amount of profit. However, a universal locomotive from Switzerland, very long lasting, thanks to the so-called Buchlied drive. Or Buchlied, now I know it's Buchlied drive, but I can see how Englishmen would pronounce this Buchlied. Alright, don't know what that is, but whatever, this is what we want. So, what we're gonna have to do is quickly, well actually not quickly, we need to convert our tracks to electrics. And that's needed because of profits. Man, I feel so stupid. Well, I didn't really knew this was coming, but I feel so stupid for buying this second train over here. It's not even a year old and already it's up for replacement. Wow, that's bad planning. Yeah, that's really poor, a poor job on my end, but I'm fine, you know, that's the way it is. Hooray for preparations, right? Oh man. Right, okay, so we need to convert all our tracks to electrics then. Tools. Electrification. That sounds interesting. What does that cost me? That could run into, I mean, look at our network, you know, if I need to electrify all of this, this could become really expensive. Oh man, can I drag? No, I need to do this section by section. Vehicle in, right, okay, so, yeah, about that, huh? You know what? I'll be back in a moment, you know, with a very nice edit / fade to black, and I'll have everything electrified. So I'll see you in a bit. And here we are, back again with, hopefully, all but one of the pieces of track electrified. Now, the very sharp ones amongst you, the viewers, will see that we did skip like half a year electrifying all our tracks. And that is because, well, you know, this could have been implemented in the game a lot more smoother, and I definitely feel like this could use some improvement, because you cannot replay or electrify a track whilst there is a train on that segment, and furthermore each segment is separated by junctions. So what you do have is you have these very long sections where there's almost always a train on it, which are very hard to electrify. And then you have these very small sections when there's crossings and split-offs and junctions and whatnot that you are very easy to overlook. However, they do tend to be in the same type of places in the network, so with this, hopefully, it should all be covered. I mean, one of these places is this one, you see? This is one of those places. The junctions here, and when there's a merge of, like, three tracks. So, fingers crossed I covered them all, and if not, we'll notice it soon enough. Now then, with that, we are going to set up some train replacings. Oh yes. We don't need all of them replaced straight away, but you know, all of the passenger ones, the quick ones, we are definitely going to replace. And I don't want to do it at a 100% age, so we're gonna set it at a, the 25%, so that they become instantly replaced. Look at this, man. It's cheaper. Oh, it is a lot more powerful. And yeah, it is better in every single way. Nice. Right. So, well, the other thing we could do is do this all manually, but now I'm gonna let the train replacement stuff do this for now. So we'll have to set that there. 4 for these. Yes, replace those. And I'll quickly have to set up all of this, you know, but just in general, you know, lines like these, the Brightling Sea Southwell, which are only running a very small loss, you know, and sometimes a profit, they will become definite profit makers. So yeah, this is good. 17 minutes for the Brightling Sea goods. That is not good. Are you again still loading over here? 5 out of 24. Yes, you are loading there. It's just that the coal production is what's keeping this back. 17 minutes. You know what we're gonna do? I'm gonna set you to load if available, so you'll turn around, and then I'm gonna set it to full load any again. Just to shave, look at that. See, Brightling Sea Goods, instantly, instead of 17 minutes, it has become 5 minutes. Oh wow, such a difference. Right, I'll be setting up the replacements here quickly, so we'll be right back. Alrighty, and I set up all the replacements for all those fast locomotives, but in the process I did notice that while keeping my fingers crossed for the whole electrification was kind of justified, because yeah, I might have forgotten something over here. Look, and see, this is what I mean with those sections that don't, well, electrify very well, you know, in the whole process. Also, it's also quite annoying that I cannot electrify any of the station tracks so long as there is one train on the whole station. I mean, if I were to do that, you know, then... Oh, crap. If I were to do that, you know, I would easily be able to do the work on the lane adjacent. But apparently, the mechanics who are charged, or who are in charge for the whole electrification process, aren't as good as I am. Alright, that's my ego gone up through the roof again. let's see, we need there, and we can't really do much more until you have departed. Can do that. There is no train over here, so we'll quickly do this. And this is what I've been doing, you know, when I said we'll be right back, and I've spent like half a year. Because it's easy to electrify this, but you then need to wait for the trains to leave the station. Luckily though, I did do these sections over here, it's just that I never really got around to doing the sections over there. Now, there is a train there, and I hope you will leave the station before you there will arrive. I mean, otherwise it's gonna be another very, very long wait. Luck seems to be in the cards. Right, now we can do the rest, including all the small sections. And I believe that covers everything over there. There are still a few more, look, see, stuff like that. Yeah, and there we get train in the way. Not for long though. Bam. Right, okay. Then there was this iron ore mine, but that needs filling up, I guess, right? Don't you? Yeah, I believe it does. Wow, production. Oh, look at that. Upgrade even scheduled. So, stuff is really picking up over here. Very, very nice. Right. Well, I mean, we've been doing quite a lot of stuff over here, but we haven't really built anything other than a new bridge. And... ooh! Nice. So... electric trains, huh? Where's that? electric trains, you know? Yay! Hooray for transparent electric trains! Where the F are they, game? I don't see them. How come you say that there are electric trains over here? Perhaps that means that it's over here, that one? No. No, it's not. It's also not over there. Is the train just, generally speaking, transparent? Something going wrong? I mean, that coal train... wait. What? Right, so apparently... I mean... bug? this leaves something to be desired. I mean, where is the train? Right? I mean, it's loading. I mean, it's just going in it, but... I don't trust this. I mean, I think the game's telling me that, yeah, you know, this isn't really... well, this needs some work. Right, you know, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna, you know, end the video here. And I'm gonna see and try and figure out why we have a transparent train over here. I mean, it really is transparent. I can't even click on it. Is it the only one? Yeah, no, it is the only one for now. Which does mean, of course, that I don't need to replace this one anymore. Wow, why? Right, okay, so, well, I guess that's it. Next time, you know, when we come back, we will be having no more issues with electric trains. I'll be damn sure to make or to check that everything is electrified, and we can then continue on with expanding our ever-growing network into more awesomeness. But that and more all have to wait for next time when we play more Train Fever.